and you are grateful tonight, God, to enter into your gates with thanksgiving and into your courts with praise. We are grateful tonight, Father. Father, tonight we don't come to complain, but tonight we come as your sons and daughters.
It's too dark. It's too dark.
You, Father, we come to lift you up. We come to magnify you. We come to glorify you, Father. God, we come to mimic what the angels do in heaven, and we cry out, holy, 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 hallelujah. You are a holy and righteous God. We give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise, Father. We thank you for what you're getting ready to do tonight. Father, we bless your name, Father. Father, we pray, God, that you would have your way on tonight, God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we ask that you would touch on the hearts and move on the hearts of your people tonight, God, in the name of Jesus, Father. Father, we pray, oh God, that you would minister to our spirits tonight, Father. In the name of Jesus, we abandon ourselves to you, God, tonight. God, we yield ourselves to you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray even on tonight, Father, that you would have your way in our hearts. Father, we pray, God, that you would create in us a clean heart and renewing us a right spirit, name of Jesus, Father. Father, we give our minds to you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, your word decrees and declares, Father, that you'll keep our minds in perfect peace if we keep them stayed on you. So, Father, we focus our mind on heaven tonight. We focus our mind on you tonight, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, your word says whatsoever is pure, whatsoever is just, whatsoever love, you told us to think on those things. So, Father, tonight, in the name of Jesus, Father, we give you glory, we give you honor, Father, we give you praise, Father, we thank you for what you're getting ready to do, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, we ask, oh God, that you strengthen us tonight, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that you strengthen us in a mighty way, Father, in the name of Jesus. Strengthen your people, Father, for the journey, God, in the name of Jesus. Strengthen us, Father, Father, for the call and the assignment that you have on our life. God, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise. We humble ourselves tonight in the name of Jesus. We humble ourselves before you, God, in the name of Jesus. We cast down our crown, God. We come against pride, we come against, God, God, we come against our own egos tonight in the name of Jesus, Father, and we submit ourselves to your will, God, in the name of Jesus. Father, anything in us that's driving us away from your will, God, we ask that you annihilate it in the spirit tonight, in the name of Jesus. Anything that is hindering us, Father, God, any stumbling block, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we ask that you remove it, Father. God, we thank you, God. Father, we thank you for what you're getting ready to do in our life. God, we thank you that how you called us to be changers in the earth, in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you, Father, that you called us to be the generation that will save. God, we thank you that you called us to be the generation, Father, that will lead people to you, in the name of Jesus. And may we never forget what you called for us to do. May we never forget our assignment. May we never abort our assignment. May we never abandon our assignment, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you that you called us to be atmosphere changers. God, we thank you that you called us to bring light in a dark world, in the name of Jesus. Who are us that you are so mindful of us, in the name of Jesus? Who are we, Father, that you would choose us? Who are we, God, that you would select us? In the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Father. We thank you. We give you glory. We give you glory, God. We ask, oh God. God, we ask, oh God, that you would continue to use us for your glory. In the name of Jesus. We are your vessels. In the name of Jesus. God, use us for your glory. We are your vessels. And use us for your glory, Father. Bless us on tonight, Father. Speak to us like never before, Father. Let your word, God, let it cleanse us tonight, God, in the name of Jesus. Let it get down in our hearts, Father. Let it get down in our spirits tonight, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, let it drive out everything that's not like you, in the name of Jesus, oh, God. God, we thank you for what you're getting ready to do, Father. We speak unity in this house. Oh, God, we speak unity in here, in the name of Jesus. We speak oneness in here, in the name of Jesus, and we submit to the will of God.
I said, we submit to the will of God. I said, we submit to the will of God. We command our soul to obey you. We command our spirit to obey you. In the name of Jesus. When we want to do good, evil's always present. But we command our soul to obey you. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We submit to you. We say yes to you. We say yes to you. We say yes, God. Not just from our mouth, but we say yes with our life. In the name of Jesus, we give you a yes with our life. In the name of Jesus. And we thank you. We thank you, God. We ask that you touch our leaders tonight, Father. In the name of Jesus, strengthen them, Father. Use them for your glory, God. In the name of Jesus, strengthen them. Strengthen us as a whole. Strengthen us as a body. In the name of Jesus. And we'll be so careful, Father, to always give your name the glory, the honor, and the praise. It is in Jesus Christ's name that we will always pray. Amen. I need somebody to open up your mouth in this room and praise God. Oh, come on, Zion. I need you to really do it tonight. I feel stripped in the house. I said, I need you to open up your mouth in here and praise Him. Come on. Oh, come on. Let's raise the volume just a little bit more. Come on, with your mouth. Let everything in this room that have breath praise you, the Lord. Come on, Zion. Come on. Come on. I need to hear Zion in the room tonight. Come on. Yes, Shataye. We lift Him high. Come on. I said, we lift Him high. Come on. I said, we lift Him high. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Anybody need the Lord? Hallelujah. Anybody need the Lord? I know I need Him. I don't know about you, but I need the Lord. I need Him in the morning. Hallelujah. I need Him in the midday. I need Him, hallelujah, in the evening hour. Hallelujah. And I'm chasing after Him. I know I got up 2 o'clock this morning. I couldn't go back to sleep, so I started praying. Hallelujah. So I started praying. My son got up at 4:30, so I started praying again. Hallelujah. I'm chasing after the Lord. Come on, let's bless the name of the Lord together today. Come on. Woo! Hallelujah now. Go ahead and praise Him on those drums. Yeah. Keep playing those drums.
Tracing after you, no matter what I have to do, cause I need you more and more. I'm tracing after you, no matter what I have to do, cause I need you more and more. I'm chasing after
you, no matter what,
no matter what
I have to do,
cause
I need you more and more.
I'm chasing after you,
no matter what
I have to do,
cause I need you more and more.
More and more.
No matter what I have to do,
cause I need you.
I need you more and more.
I'm chasing after you.
No matter what I have to do,
cause I need you.
I need you more and more.
More and more.
Chasing after you.
you. I'm praising my way through just to be closer to you. I'm chasing after you. I'm chasing after you. I'm praising my way through. Just to be closer to you, closer to you. I'm chasing after you. I'm praising my way through. Just to be closer to you, closer to you.
You know that he's all you need. Come on, bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We need you more, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Come on, all those who really need the Lord, can you act like that you need him? If you know that it was not for the Lord, come on, somebody be real up in here. If it was not for the Lord by your side, amen, taking you out of everything that you got into, hallelujah, being the answer to all of your problems. If you need him, can we just praise him just a little bit more? Yeah. Hallelujah. Lord, we need you on today, Father God. We need your presence, Lord. We need your wisdom, Lord. We need your love, Lord. We need you to speak to our hearts tonight, Father God. Hallelujah. Does anybody want the Lord to speak to their hearts tonight?
Yeah.
Come on, be vocal about it. Do you want the Lord to speak to your heart tonight? Hallelujah. Come on, we'll invite him in and let's tell him to speak to our hearts. Hallelujah. Speak to my heart, Holy Spirit. Give me the words that will bring new life. Words are the wings of the morning. The dark nights will fade away if you speak to my heart. Speak to my heart, Holy Spirit, message of love to encourage me, lifting my heart from despair, how you love me and care for me, Lord, just speak to my heart.
What can we tell them?
Speak to my heart, Holy Spirit.
Say, give me the words.
Give me the words.
That will bring new life.
That will bring new life.
Come on, words on the wings.
Words on the wings of the morning. The dark night.
Come on, tell him to speak to you.
When you speak to my heart.
Oh, speak to my heart.
Speak to my heart.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Say message of love.
Message of love.
To encourage me.
Encourage me.
And you're lifting me.
Lifting my heart from despair. How you love me and care for me. Lord, just speak to my heart. Speak to my heart. Speak to my heart. Speak to my heart.
Come on, we're telling them to speak to us.
Speak to my heart. Speak to my heart, Lord. Give me your holy word. If I can't hear from you, then I know what to do. I won't go alone. I'll never go on my own. Just let your spirit guide. And let your word of advice
speak to my heart, Lord.
Give me your holy word.
If I can't hear from you,
then I know what to do.
I know what
come on, tell them you won't.
I won't go alone.
I'll never go on my own.
I'll never go on my own.
But I'm just going to let your spirit guide
and let your word abide. Say it again,
speak to
me.
My heart, Lord.
Tell him to give you his word.
Give me your holy word.
If I can't,
if I can't hear from you.
He said his sheep know his voice.
And I know what to
and I'm not going to go alone.
I won't go alone.
And I'll never go on my
I'll
own.
I'll never go on my own.
But I'm just going to let your spirit guide. And let your word
guide. Your word
come on and tell him to speak to you.
To my heart, Lord.
Give me your holy word.
Your holy word.
Invite him.
If I can't hear from you,
then I know what to do.
Then I know what to
I
do.
I won't
go alone.
And I'll never go on my own.
I'll never go on my own.
But I'm just going to let your spirit guide. And let your word
and let your
come on, somebody tell her.
Speak to my heart, Lord.
Give me your holy word.
Give me your holy word.
And if I can't hear from you,
hear from you,
then I know what to
then do. I know what to
I will.
I won't go alone.
And I'll never go on my own.
I'll never go on my own.
But just let his spirit
let
guide
spirit
you.
Guide.
And you just got to abide by his word.
Word.
Come on, tell him again.
Speak to my heart, Lord.
Give me your holy word.
Give me your holy word.
Get it inside
if I can't
me.
Hear from you.
Let it be a part of me.
And I know what to do. I won't go alone.
And I'll never go on my own.
I'll never go on my own.
But I'm just going to let your spirit
guide.
And let your word abide.
Oh,
one more time, speak to me.
Speak to my heart, Lord.
Give me your holy word.
Give me your holy word.
If I can't
hear from you,
then I will know what to
then
do.
I know what to
and
do.
Oh, I won't go
alone. I won't go alone.
You said you'll never leave me or forsake me.
I'll never go alone.
So I'm not going to leave.
Just let your spirit guide.
And let your word abide.
And let your word abide.
Come on, speak to me.
Speak to my heart. Speak to my heart.
If you ask him, he'll really speak to you.
Speak to my heart.
Come on, say, speak to my heart.
Speak to my heart.
Hallelujah. 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 Come on, praise the Lord today, church. If you want the Lord to open up his mouth and tell you what he wants you to do, can you open up your mouth and say, Lord, speak to me tonight, Father God. Say, Lord, tell me what you want me to do. You have not, for you ask not. But if you open up your mouth and tell the Lord to speak to you, tell him what you need. Lord, make my needs your needs my needs, Father God. Make your wants my wants, Father God. Replace my whole agenda with your agenda, Father God. Replace my will with your will, Father God. Everything that is against you, Lord, I drag it to the altar, and I tell you, Lord, to speak to me, Lord. Speak to me. I'm giving it up just to hear your voice, Lord. I'm giving it up just to hear from you, Lord. I'm giving it up for a better life, Lord. I'm giving it up just to be a better person, Lord. Oh, I'm giving it up today. If you have anything that you want to give up today, I encourage you, now is the time. Now is the time to open up your mouth and confess everything that is not of God. Drag it to the altar. Tell him to take it away. Tell him to remove it. Tell him to take it out of your body. We take sickness out of the body of Christ. We take depression out of the body of Christ. We take disobedience out of the body of Christ. We take our own agenda out of the body of Christ. We take our own will out of the body of Christ. We remove it. We strip it off of us right now in the name of Jesus. Tell the Lord to strip it off of you. Tell him to strip it. You want to keep it on you, but he don't want it on you no more. He will not preserve. You cannot preserve the things that he wants to destroy out of your life. So tell him to strip it off of you. Tell him to strip it off and never let you look back again at it. You took it down. He took everything that you're about to strip off of you on the cross. And when he took it for you, he was telling you, don't pick it back up again. When he healed somebody, he said, go and sin no more. He said, don't turn around and go back to it. But when you sacrificed it, it is there. It's no longer a part of you. Let the dead bury the dead. It is not a part of you. We serve a God that is alive and that is a resurrection. He did not resurrect sickness to be a part of your life. He did not resurrect disobedience to be a part of your life. But he killed it when he went to Calvary. Does anybody know? He took it all and he sacrificed it with his life. When they hung him high and they stretched him wide. Come on, somebody. He hung his head and then he died. When he died, everything that you're about to strip off of you died with him. And that's everything. That's bad attitude. That's pride. That's sin itself. Oh, thank you, Jesus. You took sin itself and killed it, Father. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Lord. We will no longer pick it back up anymore. It is the hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah. 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 The glory of the Lord is here. Hallelujah. And let us read and recite our mission statement on tonight. Basic Ministries exists as the church of the 21st century to help, heal, empower, lead, and prosper God's people and their community in order to bring glory to our Father, which is in heaven. Why do we exist, Basics? Amen. For we know that God is a spirit, and where does he live? Amen. Do me a favor and go share some love to one of your brothers and sisters that you did not come tonight with. Hallelujah. And when you hug them, just say, the glory is here. Come on. Come on. Say, the glory is here. When you hug your brother and sister, say, the glory is here. Hallelujah, Jesus. I said, the glory. Come on. Say, the glory is here. Hallelujah. Come on, don't take it for granted. I said, say, the glory is here. The glory is here. Hallelujah. I said, say, the glory. Ah, yeah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, Selah. Say, the glory is here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
praise you, the name of the Lord. I said, praise you, the name of the Lord. The glory is. Amen. It's time for our basic news. Hallelujah. Lady Nell, when I was standing over there, I heard the Lord say that we have entered into a new realm of God's glory. Ah, some of y'all play too much. Amen. And so what I want us as basic ministries, never take the presence of God for granted. Hallelujah. Come on, Zion. He's omnipresent, Lady Nell, but his presence isn't everywhere. And I'm grateful that every time I come in this house, I've been to many churches and God wasn't there. But I thank y'all playing. I said, I've been to many places and God wasn't there. But I'm grateful that every time I, no matter what I went through today, every time I step into 1221 Pacific, I can feel the presence of God. Is there anybody that came in here tonight that's grateful for his presence? I need you to open up your mouth right here and shout. Come on, don't take his presence for granted. Come on, Zion. Come on, we can do better than that. I said, the Lord is here. Come on, Zion. I'm talking about the one that created the heavens and the earth. He reigns here. Come on. I said, we ought to give him just a little bit more better than that. How dare you sit there lethargic? God's been too good to us for us to sit here. Come on, I'm talking about the one that put the stars in the sky. His presence is here, Zion. I said, his presence is here. I've been to a lot of dead places. I said, I've been to a lot of dead places, but I thank God. Every time I walk in the door, I can feel the presence of God. Let's not get too familiar with it. It's time for baby. We play too much. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Taya shoto rabasi andio. Yetatanabasaya. Yetataya. Come on. I said the glory is here. I said the glory is here. Let's not take that for granted. The Lord himself, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's just certain stuff I just don't want to take for granted. Hallelujah. I always want his presence. Some people want money, cars, and houses, but I'll take his presence. I said, some people, it's time for basic news. Amen. Scripture today, hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'll take his presence any day. I said, I'll take his presence any day. Every time I think about him, I get grateful. Every time I think about God, here's water. I never want to lose that. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Scripture today, it definitely keeps the devil away. This week, we are in 1 Chronicles chapter 7 through 12. Hallelujah. Let us never, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. 1 Chronicles chapter 7 through chapter 12. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Got to come in the house of God with excitement. I was glad when they said unto me, we don't come here out of ritual. We come here to meet God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. Say, praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. For the name of the Lord is still a strong tower. I said, the name of the Lord is still a strong tower. Hey, and the Bible says, when the righteous run in it, come on, Zion. I said, we can run into that name. Come on. I'm grateful tonight. Grateful. I'm learning, Pastor. I'm learning to understand that the God of the universe, he speaks to us. We can't take that for granted. Come on, Zion. I'm talking about the God that created you from the dust of the earth.
He speaks to us. That's what we're saying, speak to our heart. Lord, we're talking about that God. I ain't talking about Buddha. Y'all play to come. Hallelujah. We ask, amen, during, I'm sorry. We ask that during, amen, the word of the Lord, we're asking for no walking, amen. Brothers and sisters, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, amen. During the word of God, we're asking, amen, for no walking, hallelujah. I try to learn every day, Pastor, not to take him for granted. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Our charging station, brothers and sisters, is outside. Amen. In our lobby, if you need to charge your electronic devices, we ask, brothers and sisters, that you please do it. Amen. In the respected area. Amen. Man, First Fruits with Pastor Moo every Monday through Friday, starting promptly at 7 o'clock a.m. live on Zoom. Amen. Every Monday through Friday. Meet us, amen, on First Fruits. I'm happy to report that we have fed 4,318 families here at Basic Ministries. Amen. To God be the glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you would like to be a part of this awesome ministry, please make sure that you see our very own minister, Alex. Amen. And we'll get you acclimated into this ministry. If you need groceries, brothers and sisters, please don't be ashamed. We got you covered here at Basics. We feed here every Wednesday. Amen. Starting promptly at 12 noon. We are excited about our Basic Ministries training that is available online. And we're also excited, amen, that tonight is the conclusion, amen, of the matter. Amen. Our brothers and sisters will be completing our four-week course training with Lady Nell on tonight. Amen. We're excited that they graduate this Sunday and they get their certificates. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We thankful. Amen. Some of y'all already been here, but our family is growing and we're grateful about growth. Hallelujah. Ah, sure. Ah. Hallelujah, Jesus. We're grateful about growth. Amen. We are a church that believes in what? Maximum participation. Amen. That means everybody at Basic Ministry got to do something. Amen. Amen. So we're asking, brothers and sisters, if you would like to get acclimated, amen, and be a part, you got to be a part because that's what we do here at Basic Ministries. Amen. Amen. We're grateful to serve. Hallelujah. Amen. So please make sure that you see either myself or Sister Shar, and we will get you in a ministry. Amen. We are grateful to those, amen, who was with us. Watch it, Pastor. I'm trying to get through it, but I feel the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. You be talking about me rocking, you over there rocking. Hallelujah. Amen. We are excited. Amen. Thank you. Amen. Did we not enjoy Trap Ministries this Sunday? Hallelujah. Amen. It's an honor. Amen. Amen. To be a light in a dark world. Hallelujah. Amen. We get to do this. I'm starting to understand that pastor's little sayings, they mean so much. We get to do this. Ah. Hallelujah. So, amen. Team John the Baptist, amen. You know what you got to do this third Sunday. Matter of fact, we'll all be out, amen, this third Sunday, amen, on the 20th. Amen. So we're excited. Amen. We're excited that every second Sunday that we are on a mission. Amen. 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 So, Pastor, amen, and our praise team will be at the Bay Area Rescue Mission this Sunday, amen, at 9 a.m. Amen. So we want to be in prayer, amen, for Pastor. Amen. As we go and do what we believe God has commissioned for us to do. Amen. Baptism Sunday will be this Sunday. Amen. We are excited that we have 11 candidates for baptism. Amen. 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 We're excited that they're going down in the water. Amen. Amen. So let's be in prayer for our candidates. Amen. On the 18th, we will be doing our box party. Amen. Our Thanksgiving box party. Amen. Amen. Starting promptly here at 6 o'clock p.m. Amen. Brothers and sisters, we are asking and employing everybody, amen, to help us, amen, during our box party. If you would like a turkey, amen, this would be the day that we are asking for you to pick it up. Amen. So please make sure that you are here that Thursday, November 18th, and then Friday, November 18th, and then the Saturday, November 19th, amen, we will be in Richmond, amen, at the Crescent Park Family Resource Center, amen, giving out our love and some food to our brothers and sisters there in Richmond. Amen. So we need your help there. Pastor is asking for everybody to please be there at 12 noon. And I believe we'll start giving out groceries at 1 o'clock. Amen. So meet us in Richmond at Crescent Park
11. Please forgive me. Meet us there at 11. Thank you. Amen. Meet us there at 11. Amen. Amen. And we will be getting it together. And then the very following day, amen, we are excited, amen, that we will be giving out food, amen, at Elmhurst Park. And then we'll be giving out hot food, Thanksgiving dinner, amen, on 83rd and International. Amen. Team Joshua will be at Elmhurst Park. And nope, I got it wrong. Lord, was I not just in the meeting when we just talked about this? I'm still in the glory, Pastor. Hallelujah. Team John the Baptist will be, amen, at Elmhurst Park with Minister Alex. Amen. Amen. And then Team Joshua, amen, will be on 83rd and International. On that day, Pastor is asking for everybody to please meet here at 10:30 a.m. Amen. Because at 11:30, we want to start getting everything together and dispersing to our locations. Amen. We need people to cook. Amen. Who want to cook? Our menu is turkey, chicken, macaroni and cheese, dressing, green beans, corn, rolls, rice, gravy. I didn't forget the food, Chief. Amen. We need people to sign up right now. Can I get, Lanelle, can you do a list? We need people to sign up right now. Who can cook? Amen. Amen. Mama Mary, we got you down. Amen. No, we want some good, Auntie Shar's cooking. I'm going to cook some chickens. Amen. I know we're excited to cook for the Lord's people. Amen. Amen, Sister Nell. Amen. Amen. I know you can cook more than chili. Come on, cook something else. Praise God. Sister Nell, we can get her to cook some macaroni and cheese. Who else want to cook? We need more people. Come on. Amen. Minister Alex. Minister Alex. Amen. Sign you what we can sign you up for. Everything. So we're going to get a pan of everything. I'm going to hold you accountable to that. Amen. We thank God for Uncle Curtis cooking it up. Amen. Amen. So we got the menu. We want to make sure that we feed all of our brothers and sisters. Amen. Amen. Mission trip. We are excited that we are going on our mission trip November 25th, family. Amen. We're going to Skid Row to drive the devil out. I was in L.A. the other Sunday that I wasn't here, and I saw all these crows and black birds. I said, Pat, we got to come in. I can't wait till we get out here. Got to drive these demons out of here. I said, all these black birds, and it just, and the clouds was dark. I said, Lord, but we're coming, and we're excited. Amen? Amen. I had to go and, you know, view the area before we get there, Chief. Amen. So we're excited about this. Amen. We will, if you're riding with us, we are leaving promptly. Amen. At 4:30, amen, a.m. Amen. And don't get left behind. Amen. Amen. We want to make sure, and we will leave you. Amen. Y'all heard? Amen. The train is coming. Amen. So please, family, I know y'all going to be stuffed, amen, but get up and meet us here at 4 a.m. Amen. We're also excited that we get to be with our pastor on the very next day, amen, as he ministers at the Invasion Live Musical Festival. Amen. Amen. Pastor, amen. He said he's going to do a little skit, so he's going to be calling on some of us, amen, to act a fool on the stage, because that's exactly what I'm going to do. Amen. Y'all know how we do it. Amen. Y'all doing the new song? Now, this new song, y'all, it's so dope. Amen. So I'm excited about that. Amen. And then Pastor wants us to be in uniform. Amen. So let's make sure that we please purchase our Jesus Wants You t-shirts. You can see Lady Nail. They are only $10. Amen. We're excited that Filthy Rags got some new gear coming out. Amen. So please be on the lookout for that. Amen. We got our hoodies and stuff. Amen. Amen. For us, we get a discount. It's only $45. Amen. For us. Amen. So please see Lady Nail, and you can start placing your orders now. We are excited about a basic Christmas that is happening on December 25th. Amen. And we'll be going back to Elmhurst Park giving out toys. Pastor wants to give away toys to at least 500 children. Amen. How many know that that ain't nothing? Amen. 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 So brothers and sisters, we need your help. Please make sure that anything that you see your church doing, let's make sure y'all all got social media. Most of y'all do it. Let's share it on our social media pages. Amen. To let the community know about what we're doing. We need donations. We need volunteers. Amen. And how many know it does take teamwork to make the dream work? Amen. Amen. So we're excited about this. And please mark in your calendars. Amen. On this particular Sunday, we will not be having service here. Amen. We'll be doing it at Elmhurst Park, and we're going to start setting up at 10 a.m. Amen. Amen. We're excited. It's Bible drill time. Amen. Let's give it up for Lady now. Amen. Amen.
All right. Amen. We are not doing Bible drill. We are doing something different. This game. Look at Deacon James. He came out of the foyer to come inside. Okay, this game is called Lyrically Correct. Okay, I saw this on IG and I had to buy it. So the way it goes is we are still divided in teams, Lioness versus Roll Call. I am going to read a question, and the first person who stands up, says amen, and yells out the answer, you'll get that point. Amen? All right, so pay attention. According to Kalante Gavin, oh, well, the God he serves is greater than what? Izzy. The ordinary. You got to know your gospel songs. Here we go. Somebody keep score. Nobody told Mary Mary that the road would be what? I said stand and say amen. And Shanae was the first one to stand up. Thank you. Easy. I said the first one. She popped up first. All right. This is old school. Trinity 5:7 says, God will do it for you, but first you have to know what. Trinity 5:7 says, God will do it for you, but first you have to know what. Nope. Nope. No. 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 Trinity 5:7 says, God will do it for you, but first you have to know what?
I can't hear you.
No. Nope. No. No, it's by God's grace. It's by God's grace. I told you, you got to be old school to know that one. All right, here we go. When are we going to see the king? You gotta say amen. He cheap. All right. And Jesus can work it out. What should you do after you turn your problems over to Jesus? Oh my God. Amen. Well, thank you. Where do Kurt Carr and the Kurt Carr Singers lift their hands? In the sanctuary. To give you the glory. Amen. What's that? Four to one. Four to one. I think the men got four. Lioness got one. According to William Murphy, which way is God leaning? In whose direction? In his direction. In his direction, not mine. In his direction. If the card says his direction. All right. Here we go. Here we go. Sit down. Sit down. You got the point anyway. What does Fred Hammond want Jesus to be? Tino stood up. Tino stood up. Tino, what is it? Why you stand up there? All right, here we go. According to Tasha Cobbs, what is rising up? Amen. You said amen. An army. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, last one. Giants die if we just walk around what? This. No. Jericho! The Jericho Wall. Giants die? You don't know that one? It's a song. No, you're making up something. All right. I want to do one more. Where does Dietrich Haddon want his name written?
No.
Sis. The Lamb's Book of Life. All right. Men took it.
Amen. Give it up for yourself. Amen. That was a beautiful. That was good. Amen. Amen. We're going to have fun on our game night. Amen. 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 To God be the good. Sister Shanae said that wasn't in order. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory, brothers and sisters. Amen. 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 That was good. That was fun. That was fun. That was fun. Helps you remember them songs. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. Well, we're about to get ready to go into our word. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. I heard we were praying. It's good to be where God is. Amen. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Amen. There is freedom. Amen. No restraint, no bounds. Amen. Amen. So we're about to get ready. Amen. To send our brothers and sisters that are in their basic training. Amen. This is their last class, as it was stated. Amen. So glad that they are being committed and consistent, because to grow, like I said before, to grow, it takes, brothers and sisters, consistency and accountability. Amen. Amen. So thank be to God that they're growing. Amen. They're growing. That's our job. That's my job, to grow you in the things of the Lord. Amen. Amen, that you may be effective and make an impact for God. Amen. We have a growth stage here, we have our growth stages. One, amen, we want to make sure people know God, that we want them to receive the freedom that comes from knowing God. Amen. Anybody in here free? Amen. You know that's what Jesus said, I came to do, set you free. Amen. And then And then we want to prepare you to make an impact. So it's three things that we want to make sure everybody, amen, receives from God, amen, from us. One, my job is to make sure you come into a knowledge of who Jesus is, amen, that you know him. Not know us, not know just our religious rituals, but know him, right? Amen. And in knowing him, you're going to receive freedom, amen? And then you need to, with that freedom, what do? Go make an impact. Go do something with that freedom, amen? Amen. To God be the glory. So they're going to their class, and we're going back into the book of Matthew. The book of Matthew, we left off at chapter 18. Amen. I want to say the gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 18. And we left off 17, actually. Forgive me. Gospel according to St. Matthew. And we left off at chapter 17, verse 24. Chapter 17, verse 24. Y'all like these new chairs? They kind of comfortable. Amen. Amen. God is still blessing us. Amen. God is blessing us. Amen. God will always bless where he is. Amen. If you want to be blessed, make sure God is where you are. Make sure God is in your house. Amen. I didn't even ask for these. Somebody called me and said, I got a blessing for you. Amen. That's what happens. Amen. When you are in the will of the Lord, amen, the Lord will make sure the blessing finds you. Amen, because he's doing his agenda. Amen, and he found fit and said, this is what I want y'all to have. Amen, amen, and we had to go get them. Thank God for all the brothers, the deacons of distinction. Amen. Come on, let's clap it up for him. Amen, we worked all day on Monday getting this stuff up in here. And we have more, so if you need some for your house, we got some chairs for you, dog. When he blessed you, he did exceedingly abundantly, pressed down, shaking that gal. I said, good God almighty, what are we going to do with all this? We're going to give them away. If you know any church, anybody that needs them, any organization, freely receive, so freely give. Amen? We want to give them. Amen? With no cost. Just come get them. Amen? We're going back into the gospel according to St. Matthew. Some quick Bible trivia. How many books are in the Bible? How many? Old Testament, New Testament. Amen, amen. According to the Old Testament, how many books did Moses write? I'm going to listen to it. You got to read and comprehension. According to the Old Testament, how many books did Moses write? How many books did Moses write in the Old Testament? Five, amen. And we call those five the what? The Torah or the Pentateuch. Pentateuch, pento means five. Moses wrote the first five books of the Old Testament. Amen. Amen. Establishing a people. Amen. Being a people. Amen. Isn't it very interesting that we made the people? It was one thing that brought them, two things that brought them out of, that brought them from slaves into being sons and daughters of God. One, they were chosen by God. Two, amen, God gave them his word. Amen, God gave them his way. What makes us and being the children of God is one, that we must be chosen by God, born of God's spirit. Amen, but also that we follow the way of God. It's very important. I was talking to my brother on the way here, and we were saying it's very important that we all get a system or a way that brings us to success, because success is not happenstance. You don't stumble up on success. Are y'all listening to me? God will give you strategy. He will give you a way that will lead you to success, right? And coaching, when I coach sports, I wasn't walking into the game per se, hoping per se we gonna win. I developed a strategy. I developed a way that has been proven. And if we just do it this way, 9 times out of 10, guess what's going to happen? We're going to win. You have to develop that same thing with your life. You need a strategy. You need a routine. Right? You need a routine. Now, routines are boring. Are y'all listening to me? But they're necessary.
They're necessary. You got to know when you wake up, what you doing? What are you going after? What's your routine? What do you do first? What do you do second? Are y'all listening to me? You have to gain a routine that makes you strong. You have to make sure you have a routine that brings you closer to God. You have to make sure you have a routine that if you're starting to, that you're not overloading yourself. Are y'all listening to me, brothers and sisters? Strategy is everything. Strategy is everything. First thing I do when I wake up and I open my eyes is I seek the Lord. I go into prayer. First thing, right? We might turn on the news to see what time it is because we're getting dressed. But after that, I turn on some word. First thing I do in the morning, I turn on preaching while I'm getting dressed, getting me that word in me. Then I jump on First Fruits with all my other brothers and sisters, and I get into some prayer. Are y'all listening to me? Then depending on what my job is, and I go in, I start praying with them brothers and sisters. This is a routine to keep me strong. Does that make sense, brothers and sisters? And I don't let anything block that routine, even me. If I'm tired, I'm still going to do it. Then I go in my office and I open my word for myself. And then I start work. Does that make sense, brothers and sisters? You got to have a routine. Amen. Amen. That was just free. Amen. Amen. First New Testament. How many books are in the New Testament? How many books did Paul write? 13. Some believe 14, which is the book of what? Hebrews. We don't know if it was Paul. Some believe it was Paul or Apollos. Amen. Amen. According to the 27 books of the New Testament, how many are considered the Gospels? 4, which are what? And John. I would almost say 5. Amen. Because I would say Acts. Right? But the Acts is the Gospel in motion. Are y'all listening to me? The Acts are the Gospel alive. Because one thing about the Gospel, it's supposed to be alive in our life. Amen? Amen. All right, let's go to the Gospel according to St. Matthew. Amen. Matthew's secular job, what was he? He was a tax collector. Amen. What tribe did Matthew come out of? The Levitical tribe, Levite tribe. Amen. And that tribe was known as the what? The priesthood. Amen. No wonder Matthew's name means what? The gift of God. Amen. When you come, amen, proclaiming the gospel, amen, teaching people the word of the Lord, amen, lifting up the Lord, amen, teaching people how to follow in the way of the Lord, you are a gift from God. Good God Almighty. Are y'all listening to me? Amen. You are the gift. Amen. To God be the glory. So let's go back into the gospel according to St. Matthew chapter 17. And we are starting back off at verse 24, 17, 24. Matthew 17, 24. Let's go.
Matthew 17 and 24. And when they were coming to Capernaum, they that received tribute money came to Peter and said, doth not your matter pay tribute?
Your master. Amen.
Your master, I'm sorry, pay tribute. He said, yes. And when he was come into the house, Jesus prevented him, saying, what thinkest thou, Simon? Of whom do the kings of earth take custom or tribute, of their own children or of strangers?
Stop right there. So they're asking Jesus, do your master pay tribute to the king? Tribute was a token, a tax, an appreciation to the king, to Caesar. Amen. Because these are people that have been colonized by Rome. Amen. And so the people asked, do your master pay tribute to the king? That's what they asked Peter. Amen. And Peter didn't even ask Jesus. Amen. I can't find it anywhere in the Bible. Amen. That Jesus said he has come to pay tribute to a earthly king. Amen. But Peter said yes. Peter said yes. Amen. Peter said yes. One thing interesting about that. Amen. Because God did ask for us to follow the rules of the land, right? God did not ask us as children of God to be disobedient to the laws of the land, as long as the laws of the land don't go contrary to the word. Now, if the laws of the land start going contrary to the word, God ain't going to ask you to do that. Amen. But as long as the laws of the land are in agreement with the word, it is our job, amen, to be a law-abiding citizen. I hope everybody voted on yesterday. Amen. Are y'all listening to me? Amen. Amen. He said, yes, our master does that. Amen. He'll pay tribute. Amen. And then Jesus asks Peter an interesting question. He asks Peter the question, amen, because Peter spoke up on the behalf of Jesus, amen. So he asks Peter, he said, who, he says, do the king of this earth take custom or tribute on their own children or on strangers? He asks Peter, he said, who do you think the king is getting this tribute from? Who do you think this king is making pay an alliance to him, bow down to him, his children or a stranger? Let's go ahead.
Peter said unto him, of strangers, Jesus said unto him, then are the children free. 27.
So he says, a stranger. So the king is not asking for the children to pay tribute. Because they're his children. They're born of him. They are him. Amen. So he asks his strangers to pay tribute. He asks his strangers to pay tax. He asks his strangers, amen, to make sure you're bowing down. Because my children are already submissive. My children are already carrying out my agenda. One thing they why they were paying tribute to make sure we know that you're with us. Are y'all listening to me? You're paying tribute, so we know you rocking with us. And if you don't pay tribute, you ain't with us. He said, but I shouldn't have to do that to my children. Because my children are already with me, right? So he lets you know the king's children then are what? Free. That they're free from paying tribute. They're free from attack to God because they're free. Amen? God has set us free, brothers and sisters. Jesus has set us free, amen, that you're not bound by anything. You're not tied up by anything, amen, hallelujah. God came to loose you. When you have received Christ, amen, you are loosed. It is the enemy that wants to make you think you're still tied up. That's what even our brother preached Sunday when he said God showed him a vision and he gave him the old sword, amen, because Jesus already did what he did on the cross. It's already done. It's already finished. You just got to walk in it. Are y'all listening to me? You just got to receive it. Amen. He said, we're free. He said, the children are free. So this is how free we are. Go ahead.
27. Notwithstanding, lest we should offend them, go thou to the sea and cast an hook and take up the fish that first cometh up. And when thou hast opened his mouth, thou shalt find a piece of money that take and give unto them for me and thee.
He said, we're so free, brothers and sisters, that when we are faced with a need, amen, we're so free that we can find the answer in strange places. He said, we're so free. Amen. That when I'm faced with a need, or I need some money to pay my tribute to the king, he told him, go fishing. Now, how would money be in a fish's mouth? That's how free you are. You're so free that all you have to do is ask God what you need. You're so free that if you are in need, amen, all you got to do is ask God. All you got to do is speak it into existence. Are y'all listening to me? God will make your blessings show up in strange places. Money shouldn't be in a fish's mouth, but it's there because it's needed. We're so free that everything God made will fall subject to us. Good God Almighty. Are y'all listening to what I'm saying? That's how free you are, that if you don't need it to rain, tell the rain, don't rain till I'm getting done with this. In other words, nothing can stop you. Nothing can stop you when you're moving according to the agenda of God and you're God's children. Another thing I like in this, that he got the money from fishing. Right? Another analogy for fishing is what? Evangelizing. Right? God pays you when you evangelize. Are y'all listening to me? God blesses you when you evangelize. When you win souls. Are y'all listening to me? Amen. The fish, your resources, your blessing comes from the fish that you reach. Are y'all listening to me, brothers and sisters? Amen. You don't know when you're evangelizing to a person who that person is. See, when God gives ready to give you resources, he doesn't give you things, he gives you people. Are y'all listening to me? Because with every person comes resources, gifts, talents. You don't know what that person has in them. Are y'all listening to me? But I guarantee you, everybody you fish out is connected to some form of resources. So if you want resources, don't just go looking for tangible stuff or things. Go get the people. Go get the people. Go fish it. Go networking. Are y'all listening to me? God want to give you people, not just stuff. I was saying that even at my job. I say, God puts it on people's heart. And they come in here and just give $1 million. I watched them raise $300,000 in 2 hours. No, seriously. And it ain't the money, it's the people. They don't got the money, they got the people. Good God, am I y'all? And if you got the people, you got the money because the people got it. Are y'all listening to me? That's, once again, give and it shall be given. Good measure, pressed down, shaking together, ran over, shall men, people give unto you. God is in the people's business. Are y'all listening to me? This was one of the scriptures that I really held fast on why we do the evangelizing, why we do. Because I recognize my blessing is in the mouth of the people. Are y'all listening to me? That's why we out hitting the block. Because I don't know that one person we going to fish out what's in their mouth, what they really have. Are y'all listening to me? Your blessing is in the people that you win for Christ. Your blessing is in the people that you evangelize for Christ. It's not a, God doesn't give you stuff. For stuff, God gives you stuff for people. We want stuff just to have stuff. But God doesn't give you stuff for stuff. God didn't give us these seats just for to have seats. He gave you the seats for people. That means there's going to be more people. You got to want people. You got to love people. You got to go after people. You cannot isolate yourself from people. Your blessing is in the heart of the people. That's why the enemy wants to keep you separated from people. That's why he don't want you to serve the people. Are y'all listening to me? I gave an analogy that it was a missionary team, and they went out and they did a great work. They put all type of resources and finances in their evangelistical efforts, and only one person gave their life for that whole week. And the evangelism team, they were actually upset. Like, we spent all this money. We did all of this, and only one soul? But that one soul that gave their life was Billy Graham. And how many souls did he win? Are y'all listening to me? See, you really don't know who you be talking to. You don't know what God is going to do with them. You don't know how God is going to raise them up. Are y'all listening to me? And that evangelist team that did that is connected to all the souls that Billy Graham won. Are y'all listening to me? People, people, people. That's what God is after. If God ain't going to make you rich for you just to be rich, God makes you rich for people. You want to be rich? Show the Lord how you're going to bless people. Show the Lord how you're going to serve people. And you can't say, when I get it, I'm going to do it. You're lying. Are y'all listening to me? If you ain't serving him now, you definitely ain't going to serve him when you got it. Are y'all listening to me? God has called us to be servants of when you, I'm trying, that's why we say serve, maximum participation. Radix, I'm trying to get you blessed.
Yeah.
Are y'all listening to me? Every blessing I had came from a relationship I had. To this building, to everything I've ever received, came from a relationship that I served, that I helped. Are y'all listening to me? That's where it comes from. People, you cannot divide yourself. You don't want to be at odds. Amen. You want to serve people. You get blessed. Just that simple. I was telling my brother today, I said, can you look at all these people we're around all day? All I deal with is people all day. Black people, white people, Latino people, Asian, just people. I pray with all type of people. I pour into all type of people all day. And I know one of these people that I touch, God gonna do something with. Are y'all listening to me? I know he is. And I'm gonna be connected to him. Are y'all listening to me? I'll be in that shelter, but I know somebody in this shelter is gonna get raised up and be talking before kings. So I give them all I can while they're at their lowest state to lift them up. Are y'all listening to me? Because I don't know. See, I don't know. I don't know. So you have to pour all you have into people. Are y'all listening to me, brother and sister? That's what Jesus did. Amen? Let's continue. Chapter 18.
Chapter 18. At that same time, the disciples unto Jesus saying, who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? And Jesus called a little child unto him and set him in the midst of them and said, verily I say unto you, except ye be converted and become as little children, ye shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven.
They said, who is the greatest? That's that man stuff, right? Who is the greatest, right? And I'm sure in their mind, they're thinking, is it the most well-spoken? Is it the one that has the biggest following? Right? Is the one that knows all the word. And Jesus didn't call a man. Jesus called a child. Notice that they weren't talking about no child. They were talking about a man. He's a grown man. Are y'all listening to me? And Jesus totally shook him. He went and got a little baby. He said, come on in here. He said, except you become like this, you can't even come into the kingdom of God. Because the greatest person in the kingdom of God is God. It's Jesus. Ain't nobody greater than Jesus, y'all. Are y'all listening? That's what I tell preachers. If you're going to preach, you better preach on this side. When you go to heaven, ain't nobody preaching. There's only one preacher in heaven. Don't nobody want to hear you in heaven. When I got Jesus sitting right in my face. You are not important in heaven. Better do your job on this side. Are y'all listening to me? But he said, but you got to become a child concerning God. It's not about being great, like according to man's standards, right? Because God is the one that does everything. Well, children are meant to be taken care of. Children are meant to be obedient. Children are meant to submit to their parents. So he's letting us know, if you can't become like a child, if you can't submit, if you can't be obedient, amen. If you can't follow instructions, amen, you can't even enter into God's house because he's the greatest. You can't come into God's kingdom with your chest poked out. You ain't even going. That's pride. And truly, in these days and times, what's really making it hard for people to see Jesus, amen, is that we got too much of ourselves in the way. We trying to be great. It's not my job for me to be great. It's my job to submit to the great one and continue to make him great. Are y'all listening to me? We trying to get above Jesus. We don't want him talking about Jesus. We want him talking about us. Are y'all listening to me? It's the truth. It's the truth. But we're supposed to be children. We are children of God. And there's a certain liberty and there's a certain freedom that comes in when you're a child. I was too quick to grow up. Because there's a certain liberty when you're a child. God said, no, you're my children. My job is to take care of you. My job is to provide for you. My job is to instruct you. Right? You're supposed to follow the will of your parents when you are a child. And don't let your child come in. Now, this is new way. Don't let your child come in telling you what they're supposed to be doing, what they're doing. Is that what we do with God? Majority of our prayers is about what we want. We keep praying for God to do what we want. Instead of asking God, what do you want? Ooh, are y'all listening to me? Is the majority of your prayer requests praying about your agenda or about his agenda? Have you ever asked his agenda? Right? Because you can't, don't ever go, my kids will tell you this, in my house, it's my agenda. Are y'all listening to me? You cannot run your agenda in my house. You can add to this agenda. Are y'all listening? You can take the agenda to another level, but you cannot come into somebody else's house and do your own thing. And that's what people want to do. They want to go, they're trying to be great within themselves. They want to come in God's house and be them. Oh, you got it all mixed up. Your job is to add to the Father's agenda. Your job is to advance the Father's agenda. Your job is to be a steward over the Father's agenda. He didn't tell Adam to take control, do your own thing, Adam. He told Adam, this is what I give you. He said it on. He said, now just be a good steward over my stuff. Because it ain't your stuff. That's my stuff. That's why he said, you see that tree in the middle? You can't eat of that tree. One of the reasons he would tell you can't eat that tree, so you will know I run this. It's quiet. Are y'all listening to me? Yeah. Yeah. But if you could be humble enough to clean your daddy's house and wash the dishes. Are y'all listening to me? What an honor. You ain't going to have to pay for the rent.
Oh!
You ain't paying the house, no. You ain't paying the bill. He said, no, this is my house. I'm going to take care of you. But I just need, when I say clean and wash my dishes before I get on, just have my stuff ready. And everything else, you can live for free. See, one thing I found out even about us, and this is what the devil made, we can enjoy all the perks and the fruit of the Father's house, but we can't run it. This is what the devil did. This is what pride does. It makes you overlook the blessing and the fruits that you live in for free. Because you want to run the house.
Yeah.
That was the thing with the prodigal son. It wasn't about money. Because he told you in my father's houses are servants. So that lets us know he was already wealthy. Because the daddy was what? Wealthy. It was that he wanted to run the house. Yeah. Give me your stuff and let me do my own thing. You can. This is what he told God. This is what he told Adam. You can eat everything in the house. Talking about the garden. Except for that one tree. Because that will make you like God. Right? Knowing the knowledge of goodness. That's what the devil told him. But you can eat everything else. You can kick it. But you just can't run the house. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
His job is to run the house. Your job is just to enjoy it and be a steward over it. Ain't that good? That's good. But the devil makes you want to run the house. Because, are y'all listening? But you forget he is the one that built the house. So our job is just to enjoy the house. Add to the house. Does that make sense? Add to it. Father, can I Father, I think if we painted this, that might look better, Father. He likes that type of stuff. He likes creativity. Make it better. But don't try to be the Lord of the house. Don't make the servants your servants. That's what Satan did. I'm going to exalt my throne above the throne of God. I want them all to bow down to me. And when you start trying to run the house, instead of just enjoying the fruits of the house, you get kicked out the house. Give me my key. I told you don't do that. I told you to act right. I told you, well, but now you want to do your own thing in my house? Give me my key. Are y'all listening to me? So it's not about being great and trying to be somebody. It's about submitting to the one that is somebody. That's all the prodigal son had to do. Enjoy the daddy. Are y'all listening to me? Let's keep going. Amen.
Verse 4, whosoever therefore shall humble himself as this little child, the same is greatest in the kingdom of heaven.
So the greatest person is not the most well-spoken person. It's not the most gifted person. It's the most humble person. That's the greatest person. Are y'all listening to me? That's the greatest person. No wonder it says Moses was able. The Bible speaks about Moses. Because Moses led millions of people. And one thing about the Bible says about Moses is that he was one of the most humblest, meekest men to walk this earth. Ain't that what it said? No wonder God could entrust him with leading millions of people. You can't put nobody that's prideful over something large. They're going to destroy it. Are y'all listening to me? I've watched people that God gave large blessings to. They didn't walk out with big robes on, all that. They walked out with bald caps and teachers. How you doing, sir? God bless. They shook it. And I'm like, man, do you know who you is? And you just walking out here like a regular old Joe. Yeah. Right? That's why God could trust them with something like that. You can't trust prideful people with power. Because they're going to use their pride is going to destroy people. God, once again, God is not giving you power, influence, resources, and wealth, amen, to tear down people. He gives it to you to build up people. But in order to build up people, you have to be humble. You have to know how to esteem others above yourself. But if you always need to be seen, are y'all listening to me? If you always need to be heard, if it always has to be you, you will stagnate the growth of those that are around you. Are y'all listening to me? Sometimes you got to get out the way. Are y'all listening to me? So the greatest in the kingdom of God is the most humble. Is the most humble. You're not a leader if you lead with your title. I just dropped a bomb. You're not a leader if you got to leave. I got to walk through and say, hey, I'm Pastor Mustafa. That's prideful. Are y'all listening to me? You may not really be a pastor.
Half of the time you ain't.
Because if you're walking in the gift and you're really, and God really has esteemed you to that level, are y'all listening to me? And you notice what he, you can go lower. You can go lower. Does that make sense? That's what they didn't get about Jesus. Why would God hang around people like them?
They didn't get it.
See, that's what was throwing them off about Jesus, because they thought that the Messiah was going to come with a very prideful, pious, I'm the man, nobody can tell. And that's what people like, because that's who people really want to be, because that's singing. People love people that walk around their leaders walk around like that. They like that.
Yeah, they do.
They don't really like leaders that say, nah, I ain't tripping off none of that. Let's just stay humble. Ah. Are y'all listening to me? Because the sin in them wants to do that. Are y'all listening? The question was, who's the greatest? I want to be somebody, Jesus. That was the question. I'm trying to be somebody. And Jesus says, you want to be somebody? Be humble. Be nobody. Now you're great. Be nobody. Make yourself of no reputation. Now you're great.
They don't want to hear that.
Nah.
That's too hard for the kingdom.
That goes against our very nature, sin. Because our very nature want to be somebody. Hey, y'all, listen, I want to be something above me. I want to walk in, everybody call my name. Say, hey! God told me this one day. I was talking to Pastor Jones. And Pastor Jones, very humble man. Pastor Jones was staying all night. His church is on 83rd. And he said, I'm out here ministering to him all night. He put his pulpit right on 83rd, on 85th, where it's in front of his church. And I went over there, and he was out there all night. I said, what you doing? He said, I'm out here all night ministering. And I hugged him. We talked, whatever. And God posed me a question. He said, Mustafa, would that be enough for you? If all I called you to do is just do the block, and that's it. Is that enough for you? Is God talking to my appetites?
Yeah.
Or do you got to have something big and grand and big and all of that? Because there is no difference in the reward. From the person that got the big and the person that sits on the block, because the reward comes from obedience. Oh, are y'all listening to me? God don't give him more because he's big and gives him little because he's little. No, God gives according to obedience. If he built that big thing and God didn't call him to do that and call him just to be on the block, he don't get nothing. Are y'all listening to? But God was testing my appetite. Are you satisfied with just being obedient? Are you trying to be the greatest too? But I mean, that's how God taught. God would say, sir, that's it. Because it really checked my motives. Would I be enough just to do this? If this was it, and there ain't no strip mall, there ain't none of that. This is it. And it's all God called me to do. Would I be satisfied? Yeah. See, he was talking to me like that. I'm driving home like, ooh, good question, Lord. And it had to make me check my motives. Or am I like the disciples trying to say who's the greatest? Yeah. The greatest, according, what measure are you measuring against? Right. What do you measure greatness? That's it. What do we measure the greatness of the church? What do you measure who's great in the church of Kingdom God? How do you differentiate that? Is it about how loud they can? Is it about, what do you use? God uses humility. God uses the people that just sit at the door and welcome you in and give you water. And they happy with that. Say, come on in. You're good. Can I give you something? God bless you. You're all right. You need a fan. I'll be ready. God sometimes measures that more great than the person that's standing in front of you that needs to be heard.
Yeah, right.
You know how, but we don't see that because everybody runs for the stage. Are y'all listening to me? And if God calls you to be on the stage, amen. But God is looking for who will serve my people. Who will serve? Who is the servant? Who will go cook for others? Are y'all listening? He's looking for who's running to that. Are y'all listening to me? See, if you run to the stuff that people don't see and you don't get applause for and you don't, then God will expose you.
Yeah.
Oh. Are y'all listening to me? The first place God taught me how to preach, it wasn't in front of church people. It was in front of people that couldn't give me nothing. At the Bay Area Rescue Mission, outside of my home church, is where I really learned how to preach for the Lord. That's where he trained me at. Are y'all listening to me? And now he sent me back, and I'm reaping what I did 10 years ago.
Hallelujah.
15 years ago, right? But I didn't get nothing from that. Nobody knew I was doing that. I wasn't getting no applause from that. Half the people don't even know what the heck I'm talking about. Are y'all listening to me? But are you running? But what is your appetite? What are you thirsting for? If I called you to come do a ministry in front of people and you run to that, and you don't run if I called you to go hand out plates, something is wrong. Because it's all the same thing. I'm serving spiritual bread here. We're serving physical bread there. But it's all just still being a servant. But to be a servant, you have to be humble. You have to be humble. You have to be, it's an honor. He humbled himself to the death on the cross. He humbled himself. Jesus said, you want to be great? You got to be what? Humble. Humble is the way. If you lower, if you abase yourself, God will raise you up. But if you exalt yourself, the Father will tear you down. Are y'all listening to me? Amen. Continue. So what does God measure greatness to? I want to make sure we all hear. What does God measure greatness to?
Humility.
Humility. Humility, humbleness. Amen. If when you go somewhere, shake everybody's hand.
Amen.
Shake everybody. Say hello to everybody.
Right.
When God don't act like you only talk to certain people, trying to be important. The only person important in here is Jesus. I'm not important. You're not important. We're all children in the Father's house. Amen. The only person that should be getting exalted and reverenced is Jesus. Everybody else, you second. You are last. Amen. Come on.
Amen.
No more.
Verse 6, but whosoever shall offend one of these little ones,
uh-oh,
which believe in me, it were better for him that a millstone were hanged about his neck, and that he were drowned in the depth of the sea. Woe unto the world because of offenses, for it must needs be that offenses come, but woe to that man by whom the offense cometh.
He said, if you offend one of my children, I'll deal with you. Right? If this person is humble, this person is lowly, and because of your pride, you offend them. God said, I'm going to deal with you. He's not just talking about all persons. You know, we read this guy, children, but no, he's talking about the humble ones. So he's talking about it, because those are really my children, because I'm humble. Jesus is very a humble man. Y'all understand that? He was humble. He humbled himself to the Father, to the will of the Father. Even though he was equal with the Father, he humbled himself to the Father and made himself of no reputation. He would heal people and tell them, don't say nothing.
Say nothing.
Now, y'all know, including myself, I'm telling you to share the flies too. But I'm just saying, right? We're going to go tell somebody. He would do something great and tell you, don't say nothing. And then look at that. Look at the difference between us and him. Think about that. Something that would exalt him. Something that would lift him up. Something that would make people say, ooh, look at you. When he did it, he told everybody, don't say nothing. I don't want people to look at me like that. Right now, I'm pointing them to the Father. And he knew, huh? Now, I was going to say, and he knew, when you are really walking in power in this world, they're going to hate you for it. You do understand, as a child of God, the world hates you. They're supposed to hate you. If they don't hate you, you might be a part of them.
Right.
So he understands. So what we are looking, see, what we be looking, let me say, especially in America, what the problem with the church here is, we're trying to be something in the world. Right? When technically, the people you're trying to show off in front of, they don't like you. They can't wait for you to fall so they can put a noose around your neck. But they don't like you. Have you ever tried to prove yourself to somebody? They don't like you. They don't like you. This world don't supposed to like you. Does that make sense? So why try to be something before them? Why try to show off before people that don't even like you? Am I making sense, brothers and sisters? He says, but in this world, it is what he said, offense is going to come. Because we are in this world that works contrary to his will. This world will not humble itself to the Father. Do you know this world, this whole world is God's? The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. God and the world that God made everything. But you know what mankind did? We took it. This is what we're going to do with it ourselves. This is God's stuff. God made all that. World, but men won't humble themselves in the house of the Lord. Are y'all listening to me? So he says, offenses are going to come, but woe to the one that's crazy enough to be offended. Do the offense. Now, see that? He knew Judas was going to betray him, but then he told Judas, boy, you should have never been born. Are y'all listening to, like, you really got you crazy enough to do it? Whoa. So he said, no, they gonna hate you, they're gonna offend you and all of that. But wow, woe unto them that do it. Are y'all listening to me? I'm gonna deal with them. Why? It's my house. That's what I would tell my son. You come in my house. Son, I got this. I got it, son. No, this is my house. You come in my house and try to take the first person you're going to run into is me. Not them, me. Right? Because that's my job. See, you can't say you own a house and don't protect the house. You can't say you own a house and don't provide for the house. Right? No, if it's your house, you're supposed to be the protector, the provider, and so forth. Amen? Amen. God says, you my children. I protect you. I got you. Don't worry about it. You hold your peace. Hold your peace. Hold your peace. I'll fight for you. Right? Because how dare them come in my house doing crazy to my guests. No, I'm offended. When they offended you, they offended me. Does that make sense, brothers and sisters? You don't have to fight people. You don't have to get into quarrels with people. When you know you've humbled yourself. Are y'all listening to me? Amen? Go a little bit more. Verse 8.
Amen. Verse 8. Wherefore, if thy hand or thy foot offend thee,
make it more personal.
Cut them off and cast them from thee. It is better for thee to enter into life halt or maimed rather than having two hands or two feet to be cast into everlasting fire.
Go ahead.
Verse 9. And if thine eye offend thee, pluck it out and cast it from thee. It is better for thee to enter into life with one eye rather than having two eyes and to be cast into hell fire.
And what he's talking about is if your hands, if your eyes, lust of the eyes, lust of the flesh, what is causing you not to humble yourself to the Father? Good God Almighty. Are y'all listening to me? What has caused you to want to do your own thing? Notice how he said it's offending you. Ain't that good? It's not, it's keeping you from your blessing. I told one guy today, because he was mad, he said, man, I be doing good to dudes in here, man. They be trying to take my car. I said, but if you're doing good, you're the blessing. That's their loss. Right. Y'all listen to me. If I did you good, if I loved on you, if I knew I humbled myself to you and served you, and you took my goodness for weakness and just manipulated and used me, you messed up. I didn't mess up. I'm the good thing. Does that make sense? And when I cut you off, you lacked. I didn't lack. If God cuts you off, God don't lack. You don't want to need him. He don't need you. Let me humble. Let's get humble in here. God don't need not one of us. He's all sufficient. Everything God needs, he already has. Are y'all listening to me? He said, if you don't praise me, rocks will start praising me. I'm not tripping off that. Are y'all listening to me? You need him. Pride will start making you think he needs you. Have you ever told God, I ain't doing that no more? Then don't do it. God will replace you in a heartbeat. Are y'all listening to me? If I ever told God, got beside myself, thought I was somebody, I ain't doing that no more. I'm cool doing all that move. He'll put the anointing on y'all. Y'all be doing it. Just like that. Moses died. Come on, Joshua. God, leaders will replace you. Are y'all listening to me? Don't ever think that God can't replace you. You're lying to yourself. Are y'all listening to me? I need him. I need this ministry. I need everything that God gave me because it's good for me. Are y'all? It helps me too. Are y'all listening to me? It's good that I'm able to serve. It's an honor that I'm able to serve. That's helping me. And I said, no, we get to do this. We get to feed his people. Don't you know you could be the one getting fed? You one decision away. I tell the brothers in there, I tell even us, I said, because the brothers, because they in here now, I'm just using my job as an analogy. When God blessed them here, now they're judging the people outside, sitting on the street. I said, man, you one decision away from being out there. I am too. You is too. You one step from being homeless. Let God take his hand off you. You'll be in them tents too. There you will. Oh, you think you're keeping yourself. Oh, no, you better humble yourself. It ain't you that's keeping you. Amen. It's God keeping you. Amen. So I'm going to go out and serve the ones and say, Lord, I'm going to serve them and help them. And I thank you. It ain't me. What's the difference? You're better than them? No, you're not. Are y'all listening to you? You dare look down on people as though you have not sinned at all? But that's what we do. We gonna look down on them. Are y'all listening to me? No, that can be you if you're not careful. Because nobody out there thought when they got older they would be out there. Are y'all listening to me? Something happened that made them quit in life. And it got so hard that they couldn't, you know what I mean? And they went to something, they went to this or went to that, right? Only thing that's not making you quit is Jesus. Gotta humble yourself. Humble yourself. Humble yourself under the mic. Are y'all listening? I need Jesus. I heard somebody praying today. I need him. I recognize. I need him. I'm nothing without him. Are y'all listening? It ain't got nothing to do with me. I didn't do this for myself. I can't sustain this for myself. Amen. I can barely, if without Jesus, I can't even control myself. Are y'all listening to me? I need him. I need, so we got to humble ourselves. And it's a blessing to serve my brothers and sisters in that situation to hopefully help them come up. Amen. Amen. God is humbling us in here today. Amen. Because he's trying to bless us. I got to bless you. I used to hate when my grandma used to say, we poor people. My flesh used to hate it. I don't want to be poor. But I got what she could. We didn't live like poor people. We had a house. She had cars. We ate good every day. But she would say that to keep us humble. Don't get beside yourself, baby. We poor people. She would say, don't take wooden nickels. And my flesh used to hate when she said that. Poor. But she was letting us know as children, we are who we are by the grace of God. Because really, we are. Are y'all listening to me? You are. You're making it by God's grace. I'm making it by God's grace. Are y'all listening to me? That's how we making it. That's how you making it. He blessing you. He's sending that money. He's doing all that. Ain't nobody in here was born in a seven-figure home. You poor. But you're rich in him. Are y'all listening to me? I know that make your skin crawl to say that. I didn't like it either. But now I get it. I'm poor in spirit. Humble. Humble. Don't get beside yourself. Right? Don't get high-minded. At least you start looking down on people, act like as though you're better. As though you don't need him. You're in trouble if you start thinking that. Don't ever look down on nobody. Just pray that it's not you. And then go try to help them. So if it becomes you, at least you already sold into your deliverance. One reason I feed people and like to do all that, just in case I ever need something to eat. I've sold into it already. Because you reap what you what. So one day, if you don't help feed the hungry and you find yourself hungry, you're going to starve too. If you don't lift people up when they're down and encourage them and motivate them, when you get down, you won't get it either. If you judge people, you're going to get judged with the same stuff that you put on them. Beware of the rocks you throw. At least they come back at you. That's why I will forgive anybody. I will help anybody. I will love anybody. I will sit down with anybody. I ain't tripping because I ain't nobody. Amen. Ain't nobody. That feels good to even say it. It does. It frees me. I ain't nobody. That's all I am. Well, who made me? I'm somebody. Lord has made me somebody. I'm somebody because I'm connected to somebody. So I'm just trying to stay connected. Are y'all listening to me? Let's. Where we at, sir? I hope I'm helping y'all. He says, but cut it off. If your hand is messing you up, cut your hand off. Make your head. Look, I'm telling you to humble yourself. Right? If your eye is messing you up from following God, pluck it out. It's better to have one eye and can't see than have your body tossed into hell. I'm telling you. Humble yourself. Judge yourself. Judge yourself. Least I will judge you. I'm going to give y'all one of my secrets. I judge myself. Are y'all listening to this? I try to correct myself before I let God have to correct me. I tell the Lord that. Give me a moment. I promise, Lord, I'm going to get this right. No, I reckon. No, 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 no. Hold on, Daddy. You keep that belt. Give me a moment. I'm going to get this right. And he does. All right, get it right then, sir. He's so gracious. Judge yourself. But isn't that how parents are? He's our father. I'll never forget when my son was young. He was a freshman in high school. You know, I used to tell that story. He did something that wasn't right. And I came in with the mentality, I'm going to judge him. I'm judging. Today is judgment day. I'm coming in with terror already. But then he came in and he said something and he judged himself. And I said, it's all right, just don't do it no more. But he showed me his godly sorrow. He showed me that he was really sorry. So now I'm abusing you. If you already humbled yourself to me. If he would have rose up in pride, it was on. Right. I just need you to say something crazy, and it's on. But he went so low, he made me want to lift him up. Say, it's okay, come on. Right. Don't even trip. Are y'all listening to me?
That's a good nugget, that's good.
If you go low, God won't judge you. Right? He said David was a man after his own heart. Yet David committed sinful acts, and God showed it to him. But didn't David judge himself? Did you see how David judged? You never seen when God came to David and said, you did something. You never seen David say, hold on, who are you talking to? I'm the king. Did you understand when that man came to talk to David and told David, you're the one? Did you understand David could have killed him? David is a king. You can't say nothing crazy to a king. But you know what David did? David humbled himself to a servant. He told the servant, you're right. And he humbled himself as the king. He could have killed him too. He could have killed him in a drop of a dime. But David was willing to humble himself to what was right. And not make excuses, even if it was him. Y'all listening to me. Can you humble yourself to a child? If a child told you something right, could you tell that child? Are y'all listening to me? Or are you going to say, I'm the king. You know who I am? I'm Pastor Musta. Come on. Humble yourself. Judge yourself. At least God will judge you. Does that make sense, brothers and sisters? So whatever wants to make you prideful and arrogant and be somebody, God say, cut it off. Cut it off because it's going to take you away from me. Your perception of being great will take you away from God. Your perception of being great and trying to reach whatever's in your head, it's actually going to pull you away from God. Humble yourself to God and just let him be great. That's it. I don't even want to be great no more. I just want to make my daddy great. I just want to exalt his name. Amen? That's it. I'm going to end with this. I seen a preacher. He fell into sin. True story. Real story. Y'all know him too. He fell into sin. He got caught, right? And instead of humbling himself, just saying, that's right. Lord, I'm sorry. Forgive me. He took a prideful thing, and they lifted him. They put scrolls around him, and they lifted him up around the whole church and all of that, and he was dead about 2 or 3 weeks later. Eddie Long. I know Miriam. And he died about 3 weeks later of some disease because God put a disease on him. Oh, you do know God can do that to you too. But he should have humbled himself. Okay, you messed up. So what? Everybody messes up. How can they judge us though they don't have sin either? Are y'all listening to me? How are you going to look to judge him and you fighting what you fight? But he was trying to be somebody in front of people. That's the danger of being leaders. Trust me. That's the danger, is that you try to make yourself a reputation. That's a danger, because if you mess up, you can't say, I'm sorry. At least that tarnishes your reputation. Am I communicating? I'm a leader. I'm telling you, that's the danger of it. What are they going to think? So what would they think? It matters what God thinks. I have nothing. I ain't got nothing to prove to nobody in here. I'm here for you. I got to be in line with my daddy. Right? But because he couldn't humble himself and say, I messed up. You know, if he would have humbled himself and said, I messed up, got right, got, you know, I almost feel like God would have restored him. Because God is the one that blessed him and raised him up that high anyway. Are you listening? God could have protected him and got him right. Okay, we're going, you know what I mean? That's all right. I'm going to show you how to make it through this. No. What are they all going to say? Well, I have made myself in my own head. Some people start putting scrolls around, doing some witchcraft, something weird. Try to make him look greater. Who's the greatest? He was dead after that. Nothing against him. God bless his soul. But no, don't ever get above, I'm sorry. Are y'all listening to me? Don't ever get above, don't let your title make you above, I messed up. Am I making sense, brothers and sisters? Don't ever, because if you can't do that, you can't never get back. See, if you never can repent, you never can be restored. When you fall into sin, what makes you come back into restoration is that you repent. If my people, which are called by my name, would humble, listen to the verse, that's the main key. You know why I can't get the glory back in them? They're too prideful. They can't say, we messed up. Because that whole scripture came out of when the glory of God fell in the temple, Solomon asked God, what do I do if the glory leaves? That's what the conversation came out of. He said, if my people, which are called by my name, would humble them. So what made the glory leave? Pride. First, humble themselves and pray. You can't even pray right if you ain't humble. I'm going too deep. Let me stop. Are y'all listening to me? You can't even pray right. I get on First Fruits in front of all these people. I don't get on as a pastor. I pray my heart. I don't get on there acting like I'm, no. I'm just praying. But I'm praying my heart. I need to be right too. For real. I'm not going to get around people and be praying like I'm, no. You're not even being open with God. Am I making sense, brothers and sisters? Let's be a great people. Let's humble ourselves to each other. Let's serve each other. Are y'all listening to me? Let's serve. If this is going to be a great church, this is supposed to be a humble church. This is supposed to be a people that come and say, how can I help you? What can I do for you? You need something, brother? You can. This is a matter we all did. This will feel like heaven. If we came in here and we was thinking about how can I help my brother and sister, when you came in here, did you think about anybody here? I'm going to stop now. Are y'all listening to me? But that's what it's about. Before I come here, I think about all of y'all. Because I'm here to feed you. Are y'all listening to me? That's why when I came in here and I seen that the lobby floor was dirty, I went and grabbed a broom. I don't want people walking in the dirty. I don't want my people walking in the dirt. Are y'all listening? I'm a servant. It don't matter my title. Does that make sense, brothers and sisters? I wasn't sweeping that lobby for me. Sweeping that lobby for the people of God. I want to make sure everything is straight for the people of God. That's how we supposed to, that's how we, God wants us to be with one another. That's how God is with us. All right, I'm done. Any questions or comments? Amen. It's easy to do, especially when God starts blessing you. See, people that get prideful, they get prideful because God is blessing them. Satan got prideful because he was the most gorgeous angel it was. He had all the jewels in him and all the trumpets and everything. Where he started thinking he was really somebody. No, God created you like that. Oh, yeah. And he lost everything. So stay humble. Keep doing what you're doing. And you'll keep what you got. When God exalts us, we ain't going on the block. We're going to do it more. Somebody asked me, what are you going to do when God, what would you do when God gave you millions of dollars? I said, I'm going to keep doing what I've been doing. I'm just going to do it harder. We're gonna do it more. I can pay now. I can pay some people to go out there and do it. We're gonna put $1 million on the campaign. I'm not gonna shift. Don't shift when the blessing comes. Y'all know y'all have friends that you pick them up in your car every day, and now that they got a car, they don't even hang out no more. Ever have people like they shift? Blessings will shift. If you're not careful, they'll shift you. One of my, I tell God, I don't want to have more and do less with it. If you give me more, I want to do more with it. Amen. Any more questions or comments? Amen. Let's remain humble. Let's remain servants. That way you remain great. Amen. I tell the leadership team this. If servitude is beneath you, then leadership is beyond you. Amen. If you feel like you're too good to hand somebody a cup of water, you can't lead in the house of the Lord. Stand to your feet. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, we want to keep the glory in here. God Almighty. Like you was praying, at least you make God comment. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we praise you. Lord, we honor you, Lord. Lord, we all get on the same page this morning, this evening. We're nothing without you. We're nothing without you. Hallelujah. No matter what people think, who we are, what we are, Father God, we're nothing without you, Master, in the name of Jesus. So let us not, Father God, make a reputation for ourselves. But like Paul said, Master, let us glorify in our weakness, that your power may be put on display in the name of Jesus. Let us be transparent, Master. Father God, not having to hide nothing from nobody. Father God, but we can tell, keep it real. Father God, so they can see how real you really are. In the name of Jesus. Continue to bless us with humility. Father God, if there's anything in our life, Master, that's trying to make us prideful, arrogant, egotistical, Father God, offend ourselves, let us cut it off in the name of Jesus. But let us humble ourselves to your will and your way, Father God. Let us not make our idols out of nothing or no one in the name of Jesus. If they don't want you, we don't want them. In the name of the Lord, Master. Father God, let us be those people that will walk away from anything and everybody, Father God, about you in the name of the Lord. We bless you. I pray, Father God, that you give us more outlets to serve. Thank you for allowing us to feed your people. Thank you for allowing us to be a blessing to your people. Who are we that we may go feed the beloved of God? We bless you, Lord. We honor you. We glorify you. As we move, Father God, from this destination to the next, be with us. And wherever we go, let us add to that place. Let us make it better. Let us make our neighborhoods better. Let us make our homes better, Master. Wherever we are at, Father God, let us impact it with your love. We give you the glory, honor, and all the praise. In Jesus' mighty name we pray, and we all say together, amen. God bless you, brothers and sisters. Hug somebody. Amen. Hug them. Love on them. Amen. Huh? Amen. Uh-oh.